I think the first question that pops into my mind is, what is data lineage? Because you have like business lineage, technical lineage.
So it's a very good question. Is that like what exactly it is? So it's a basically record of entry, which tells you that where the data come from, where it goes, right? When we say is where it come from, that means that, like, obviously the data get originated when people type the application in some of the application, and then they type some information, it goes to applications databases, from applications databases, or maybe the social media, I'm doing some work, I'm doing interaction. A human is doing some interaction with a machine, it creates data. So journey starts from there. And after that, you basically go and massage the data. You kind of transform the data, do some analytics on it, or maybe do some integrations with one data to another data. And data move from one system to another system. And as they move the data from one system to another system, understanding that and keeping the record of that, that how the system is moving, that is what the data lineage is. Of course, it moves by from technology to technology, right? It has the data stored in databases. Mostly, and from the databases, it goes to data warehouse using ETL technology, some sort of thing, and then goes to reporting system, AI models, and then from there, it gets consumed back to application or to dashboard reporting mechanism or some sort of AI models or some sort of a back consumption technique. That's where the data gets consumed. So this whole entire journey is data lineage, from source to all the way destination. And sometimes the destination may be the source back again. But that's the journey is data lineage. And then we can have two kind of lineages at the very high level. This is generally we consider as a technical lineage, how did it come from, where it goes. And then the business lineage is how is the business processes converting it? What are the business processes involved in changing the data and altering the data? Not just the technical processes, but the business process. And that's what the business lineage is. So I think kind of it's those are the data lineage at a very high level, if you want to understand this.
Got you. And what are some of the benefits of having data lineage?
Figuring out the data, where it come from, where it goes, you know, like 10 years ago, it was very complex. In fact, one of the report in McKinsey listed have found that a global bank have invested somewhere about $100 million to build the data lineage. Because at that time, it used to be super expensive to find where the data come from. You have to investigate, you have to figure it out, and then you kind of like, of asking hundreds of developers where did this come from, where that come from. It was a whole project. People were spending time and there was no technology available. And as soon as the requirement become bigger and bigger, now the technology started coming in and the various technologies started happening. And then people started finding a more and more use case for the data lineage. Now the data lineage is becoming a fundamental thing for every business that they need to keep the data lineage. And there are various benefits of the data lineage. The number one is started from the compliance. That is number one. Then it's also used to build a trust in the data. So the business people, like as the compliance people want to understand where the data come from because they could trust the report. But they, even the business people, the line of business from the credit side or from the risk side or from, any part of the business where they want to make the decisions on the data, they want to also understand where the data come from the line of business perspective. So they also need a data lineage. And then the data quality is a bigger component always. So they also need data lineage to understand where the data come from, where it goes. So they can do some root cause analysis to understand where it is. As a lot of tools started emerging into the market and we started helping this data lineage path, what it helped is to understand you can immediately identify the source, you can immediately identify the destination, and it helped to find a lot of use cases like impact analysis, et cetera, a lot more use cases that started emerging and helping customers to build the trust in the data. So if at a very high level, the compliance is the number one use case for the data lineage, the building trust in the user community is the second use case, improving the data quality is the third use case, right? And then in the entire process of that is even more and more use cases like impact analysis, et cetera, which is helping in all three dimensions as well, are the larger level use cases are there for kind of like why we need a lineage.
Got it. So to quickly summarize, you're saying that it came from that banking industry from compliance perspective, and then lineage is like very complicated. and you're saying that, you know, according to this McKinsey report, you have to spend like thousands and thousands of dollars to build it. And once you are able to get that visual representation of the flow of the data, you will improve your data quality because you're able to trace and view the source of your data. And that's how you're building trust. And then now we are also seeing many other use cases like impact analysis, data literacy. Building on that,
So one thing I would just correct it here is that it used to cost millions of dollars earlier. Mm-hmm. Now with the availability of tools and technology, it doesn't cost you that much. And that's why a lot more use cases are coming in.
Gotcha. Maybe can you elaborate on that? Like how do the current technologies work in building that auto lineage?
So earlier, back in old days, I remember that visiting a customer, 5 years ago. And they had a whole, in a conference room, they had the one wall. Actually, they have put it a whiteboard there and they were like, okay, where it's come from? Everybody used to come and explain this is what he said. So you used to draw this manually and used to take like 3 months. It took her to present it on a wall and kind of figure out the where for one model where the data was coming from, because it's, they have to investigate a lot of time. Mm-hmm. That's why I'm saying the report, which I was mentioning is, cost $100 million for a bank, a global bank, to build that kind of like the visual flow for entire spectrum for compliance reason, obviously. But then they said like the technology started emerging, and now the technologies are some of the technology which are there is like parsing the source code, which is the number one. Like, so because ultimately the data is moved by some sort of ETL program or reporting system or some sort of a program which is moving the data from one source to another source, which is the, source of truth. So overledge technology is there that which basically can parse the source code and can find the, where the data come from, where it goes, and can kind of give you the visual representation automatically. Mm-hmm. Right? So that is the one way. That's the easiest way of building the data lineage. And earlier people also use, okay, they need some sort of this is my source, this is my destination, I know it, can you just help me to just do the field mapping, column mapping? So there is a lot of other ways as well to simplify the lineage building, like from AI perspective, et cetera, to kind of give you the, like, this column looks same, so this may be coming from here. That is also another technique to understand the data lineage. But also other techniques are, when the data move from one system to another system, you move this entry to some sort of a log file, an audit entries, because then you can parse those audit log and then you can also create the lineage if the audit logs are available. Now, every technology do not provide that technique. Some only does it, some do not do it. Like, so it depending upon the connector to connector, ETL system to ETL system, reporting system to reporting system, whether they are providing those technologies and in the audit phase. And then you have AI ways. AI is like, okay, I put generally the source code is the one which put it there, but also sometimes the log files are also there. The log files doesn't have like exact entry, which is the source and destination mentioned in the log file, but some sort of entry is there. I inserted data into this table from this table, right? So you understand what exactly the log is, and from that you build trying to interpret the lineage. So because there are so many technologies and there are so many dispersed systems are there, for that the technology is the answer to kind of figure out the insights from this and build the lineage there. So there are, as I said, that there are multiple technologies and multiple way of parsing and figuring it out now exist in Overledge platform, as well as some other platform might be available, which can take this and build a lineage.
Gotcha. So to those who are just joining us, so we're just talking about how different technologies work on building lineage. So I think at a high level, you told about three technologies. One is like leveraging AI to look at the patterns. Another is like the data transformations that happen through the ETL tools. So you're able to parse the source code, and other is through the log files, because as long as it almost reminds me of, 10, 15 years ago when we did not have Google Maps, and if you had to go somewhere, you literally had to ask people. And now it's all about like, I don't even know where my house is. Like I just So
I think you have nailed it. I think this is a Google map of data. I think it look different, but it is exactly like that way.
I know.
And you believe me or not, it took a long time for Google to figure out the map. Like they literally have to trace each and every road. They put it a lot of spending to figure out, that where the roads are, where the things are, the curation of that. It took and they use multiple technologies. Mm-hmm. Like first they bought some company to kind of, which have the existing map. Then they send this van which capture this information. And now they use the real-time mobile devices to capture it. But ultimately, mm-hmm. what they're doing is they're mapping the entire system. The same thing is we are doing in the data lineage, is that we are mapping how the data is moving by finding the multiple complexities of the whatever is available, right? Yep. Because we can't ask government to, when they create the rate register, to the Google map, right? That's not happening, right? So the Google have to figure out the way to doing it. I think this is a very right way to understand the complexity of it and the technology smartness of that to understand the data lineage.
And I have worked with customers and I've seen like Ovalage parse like millions of nodes. Each node is like a table. And then like we take it so much for granted, just like we take Google Maps for granted. But then there's like so much complexity that goes behind that.